my dear students and welcome to Zenith Academy Online. My name is Shagufta Jaipuri and we are on part 3 of chemical calculations for GCSE chemistry year 11 and also for ICSE class 10.
So in this video module we'll study how to balance equations if masses of reactants or products are given. Or how to find the stoichiometry, that is the coefficients of the reactants and products if the masses are known to us.
Apart from this major concept, we'll also talk about limiting reagents, we'll also talk about the conservation of mass and such laws which help us to find the balanced equations. So first of all, let's go and understand what is law of conservation of mass. Now, the law of conservation of mass states that no atoms are lost or made in a chemical reaction. So, nothing is formed, nothing is lost in a chemical reaction, right? Instead, the atoms join together in different ways to form products. So, no atoms are lost or no atoms are made, but they rearrange themselves to form different products. This is why in a balanced symbol equation, the number of atoms of each element is the same on both the sides of the equation. In our last video, I explained to you that on the right hand side and on the left hand side of a reaction, that is on reactant side and product side, the number of atoms of the same element remains same. That is also because of law of conservation of mass. Since the atoms are not lost or made in a chemical reaction, the total mass of the product is equal to total mass of the reactant. Since nothing is lost or nothing is made, okay, the mass of the reactant side also remains the same as mass of product side. The sum of the relative formula masses of the reactants is equal to the sum of the relative formula masses of the products. You see here, the mass of one substance in a reaction can be calculated if the masses of the other substance are known. So you can see this chemical reaction in which calcium carbonate is decomposing to calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now it is forming 28 grams of calcium oxide and 22 grams of carbon dioxide. And they've asked what was the mass of calcium carbonate. So according to the law of conservation of mass, here the mass of this product, the mass of this reactant, okay, should be equal to the sum of the mass of the products, because here the mass is conserved, whatever mass was there, here the same mass should be there. So what is the mass of the product side? 28 plus 22, right? So it is 50 grams. So the mass of calcium carbonate was 50 grams. So you can say that 50 grams of calcium carbonate decomposed to give 28 grams of calcium oxide and 22 grams of carbon dioxide.
Similarly, you can find out the mass of any of the reactant or product if the masses of other reactants and products are given to you.
Now let's talk about limiting reagents. What are limiting reactants or limiting reagents? A reaction finishes when one of the reactants is all used up. So if you have taken two reactants for a reaction and if one of the reactant gets over, okay, the reaction will not proceed, the formation of product will stop. So this reactant which got over, which is in lesser quantity, is known as limiting reactant. So a reaction finishes when one of the reactants is all used up. The other reactant has nothing left to react with. It cannot react with anything because this one is not there now. So some of it is left over. The reactant that is all used up is called limiting reactant. The reactant that is all used up is called limiting reactant. And the reactant that is left over is described as being in excess. Okay. So the mass of the product formed in the reaction depends upon the mass of the limiting reactant. We just now studied in the law of conservation of mass that the mass of the product, the total mass of the product depends on the total mass of the reactant. So the mass of the product formed in a reaction depends upon the mass of the limiting reactant. Why? Because no more product can be formed when the limiting reactant is all used up. So instead of depending on the mass of all the reactants, it mostly depends on the mass of the limiting reactant. Because if once the limiting reactant is over, there's nothing left with the other reactant to react with, right? So the formation of product will hinder, the formation of the product will stop. So how much product is formed, the mass of the product that has been formed depends on the mass of the limiting reactant. So let's look at this question. If you have 4.8 grams of magnesium ribbon reacting in a solution of dilute hydrochloric acid containing 7.3 grams of HCl, which reactant is the limiting reactant? So now you have magnesium ribbon which is burning with HCl to form MgCl2 and hydrogen gas, right? So you know when any metal reacts with an acid, it forms a salt and hydrogen gas is evolved. So you have written the reaction. Now first you should balance it. Since there are two hydrogens here, you have to write two here. You have 4.8 gram of magnesium. So how much magnesium is there? 4.8 gram. Okay. And HCl is 7.3 gram. Now we'll find the number of moles of magnesium and HCl. We'll take into consideration only reactants, because here we are finding out that out of these two, which is the limiting reactant. So we will not bother about the products. Right now we'll find out the number of moles of Mg. So the number of moles, you know, is mass upon relative atomic mass or relative molecular mass in this case. So for Mg, it will be, this is 4.8 which is given, and you know the relative atomic mass of magnesium is 24, right? So when we solve this, we get 0.2 moles. Okay. Now, if we calculate the number of moles of HCl, it will be mass upon relative molecular mass or relative formula mass, which will be equal to, the mass is given as 7.3, and for HCl, hydrogen is 1, chlorine is 35.5. So it is 7.3 upon 36.5, which is also 0.2 moles, right? So here you get 0.2, here also you get 0.2. Now this is experimental values, because they have done, they have used 4.8 gram of magnesium and reacted with the solution of HCl containing 7.3 gram of HCl. Okay. So from this we can say that 0.2 mole of your magnesium reacts with 0.2 moles. But if you see the reaction, it is 1 mole of magnesium, because the coefficient here is 1 and here the coefficient is 2. So 1 mole of magnesium reacts with 2 mole of HCl according to the balanced chemical reaction. According to this, 1 mole of Mg should react with 2 moles of HCl. So 0.2 moles of Mg, okay, which is there, okay, because we have calculated it is 0.2. So 0.2 moles of Mg should react with 2 into 0.2, right? So should react with 0.4 moles. But according to calculation, we found that it is only 0.2. So which is the limiting reagent? This one. You got it? This should be 0.4 to take the reaction to completion, but it is only present 0.2. So this is the limiting reactant. So according to the balanced chemical reaction, 0.2 should react with 0.4. But according to calculations, we saw that this is not 0.4. This is only 0.2. That is why this HCl is the limiting reactant.
Now let's learn how to balance the reactions.
The balancing numbers, that is coefficient or stoichiometry in an equation, can be worked out using masses found by experiment. So if we don't know a balanced reaction, okay, we know that this reactant is reacting with this reactant to form products. And if we know their masses, then we can go back and form a balanced reaction. We can find the balancing numbers, that is stoichiometry of the reaction or the coefficient of reactants and products. So let's see how we can do this. Let's look at this question. When 8.5 gram sodium nitrate is heated in a test tube until its mass is constant, 6.9 gram of sodium nitrite is produced and some oxygen gas is liberated. What mass of oxygen must have been given off in the reaction? And produce the balance symbol equation for the decomposition of sodium nitrate. Okay. So the first question is for law of the first question needs the knowledge of law of conservation of mass, and the second question needs us to find the balance symbol equation. So first let's do this. What mass of oxygen must have been given off? Now sodium nitrate is there, NaNO3. How much is it? 8.5 gram. Right. Is heated in a test tube. So it decomposes until its mass is constant. And 6.9 gram of sodium nitrite, NaNO2, is produced. Now this is 6.9 gram. Okay. And some oxygen is liberated. And they are asking how much oxygen was there. So if this was X, so X plus 6.9 gives you 8.5 according to the law of conservation of mass. So you can find X as X is equal to 8.5 minus 6.9. So it is 1.6. So 1.6 gram of oxygen was liberated. So this question needed only the knowledge of law of conservation of mass. Now let's go ahead and solve the second part. Now for solving this part, okay, we need to follow three steps. First is write the formula of the substance. So here, according to the equation, I'll write the equation, unbalanced equation here. NaNO3 is giving NaNO2 plus oxygen. Now we need to find the coefficients for this. Write the formula of the substance. First substance is NaNO3. Second is NaNO2. And then oxygen. Okay. Now, calculate the number of moles of NaNO3. How we will calculate mass upon relative atomic formula mass. So, what is the mass of NaNO3 they have given? They have given 8.5 gram here. So, it is 8.5. Now, the relative molecular mass of NaNO3 we will have to calculate. Na is 23, sodium is nitrogen is 14 and oxygen is 16. So what will be for NaNO3? See, 23 Na(n) and oxygen is 3. Okay, so 3 into 16, so when you calculate this it gives 85. Okay, now if we so this is 85. Now NaNO2. So sodium is 23. Nitrogen is 14 plus 16 into 2. 16 to the 32. This is 69. And if you calculate for oxygen, oxygen is 16 into 2, which is 32. So now this is 8.5 upon 85. NaNO2. How much it is given? 6.9, right? So 6.9 is the mass and relative molecular mass we found out to be 69. And for oxygen we had found out in our first part it was 1.6. So 1.6 upon 32. So this becomes 0.1. This becomes 0.1. And this becomes 0.05. Now divide both by smaller amount. So which is the smaller amount? We have to divide all by smaller amount. So out of these three, this is the smallest. So 0.1 divided by 0.05 will give 2. Here also 0.1 divided by 0.05 will give 2. And here 0.05 divided by 0.05 will give 1. So we have got the ratio here 2, 2 and 1, okay, 2 2:2:1 ratio we have got. So hence the coefficient in the reaction will be 2, 2, and 1. Okay, so I'll revise how we went about. We did this in 3 steps. First we wrote the formula in the order. You can write in any order, still you'll get the same answer. Then you calculate the number of moles. So number of moles is mass upon relative atomic mass or relative molecular mass. So this is mass 8.5 gram which is there in the question. Okay, this is experimental value upon the relative formula mass of NaNO3 which gave 0.1. For NaNO2 the mass given is 6.9 and we know that it's, and we calculated its relative formula mass which was 69. So we got this answer. For oxygen, mass upon relative molecular mass. Then out of the 3 we chose which is the smallest and then divide all 3 of them by the smallest to get a whole number ratio. So the same number we assign to the same. So NaNO3 is 2, NaNO2 is 2 and this is 1. So let's do one more example. 6 gram of magnesium. Okay, so there is magnesium. Reacts with 4.0 gram of oxygen to produce magnesium oxide. Okay. Deduce the balanced equation for the reaction. So first step, write the formula of the substance. So here I write magnesium, here I write oxygen, and here I write magnesium oxide. Okay. Then calculate the number of moles. Now number of moles of magnesium is mass upon relative molecular mass. So what is the mass of magnesium given here? 6. So 6. And we know the atomic, relative atomic mass of magnesium is 24. So 6 upon 24. Okay. So 6 ones are 6, 6 fours are 24. So it is 1 upon 4. Or we can say 0.25. Okay. Now for oxygen, what is the mass? 4. And what is the relative molecular mass of oxygen? 32. So 4 upon 32. 4 8s are 32. So it is 1 upon 8. Or it is 0.125. Right? For magnesium oxide. Now for magnesium oxide we don't know the mass which is formed. But according to the law of conservation of mass, we know if this is 6 gram, 6.0, and this is 4.0, then it will be 10.0. So we can write 10 here. And for magnesium oxide, we will have to add, for magnesium it is 24 and for oxygen it is 16. So we can write 10 upon 40, which is again 1 upon 4, which is 0.25. Now, out of these 3, which is the smallest? This is the smallest, 0.125. So, we divide all 3 of them by 0.125. Now, one more thing that you should note here is, even if you don't calculate for the product, for MgO, okay? Even if you do the calculation only for these 2, you will get the coefficient of these 2. So once you put the coefficient of these 2, you can balance and find the coefficient of magnesium oxide. But right now here I am showing you the full calculation. Okay. So now divide everything by smaller amount. So this is 0.25 divided by 0.125, or you can say 1 upon 4 divided by 1 upon 8. To make it more simple, we can do 1 upon 4 into 8 upon 1 which gives you 2. So the answer here is 2. Here answer will be 1 because 0.125 upon 0.125 the answer will be 1. And here also it will be the same as 2. So we have got the whole number ratio of 2, 1, 2. So we'll write 2, 1 and 2 here and see. Okay, So even if you have not calculated for MgO, you can get this ratio 2 and 1. So once you get 2 and 1, you can say that if there are 2 magnesium and 2 oxygen, here it will be 2, right? So you either do for only these two or you can do for all the three. Still you get the same ratio. I hope balancing of equation is very clear with the two given examples. If you have any doubt, go back in the video and see it very properly and understand it deeply. And still if you have any doubts, please write in the comment section below. I'll be very happy to help you all. If you have liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and write in the comment section below. And if you have yet not subscribed to our channel, do it right away and don't forget to tap on the bell icon. And please share these videos with all of your friends and keep the learning on. Thank you and have an amazing day. Bye-bye.